Alright, so now, we left off, Joseph, the brethren of Joseph, you know, they kind of figure we'll take things into our own hands. And so they strip Joseph of the coat. This is where we find it, necessary for us to pay close attention. Now, the stripping of the coat can represent Old Testament, within Old Testament. Like we said, this is most likely not for the people of old to kind of like as a guide for them to see like the things to come and how the truth is to be made manifest via the Spirit, but rather for us that are in spirit and in truth, so that we can return to a point of origin and really overstand and comprehend in detail how it is that the manifestation came to be, you know. And so it's kind of something that we started off speaking on, but until now it's the time to actually we'll explain why it is we said that. So that's, at least that is what we receive. And the teaching here, before we get lost, is the comfort in the fulfillment and knowing and humbling ourselves to the will, to the divine will of the Almighty, you know, and that He does not depart them who live in spirit. Before we forget, because it happens continually more often times than not, it just came to mind just Acts chapter 7, where Stephen is testifying, you know. And so one of the things that stands out, that he makes mention to those that are about to do those things which they do upon Stephen, he makes mention that ye do always refuse the Spirit, as did your fathers in the wilderness. So to put that into this reasoning, into, you know, a better perspective, this is a teaching in which the brethren could not receive the Spirit. Now Joseph was in the Spirit. He was in a pit, and we are pretty sure that he was having the time of his life, because we're pretty sure that his type was humbled and just enjoying the ride, you know, for inevitably, Jah will be made manifest, and nothing else can be. No outside influence can impose upon that which is. Wisdom, being a part of one of the part of the whole, but in we as Rastafari receiving wisdom, then we can exercise the comfort of knowing that we may not know exactly what this instance is kind of like or the fullness of the recent or the whatever we're confronted with at the very at this very instance, but we have the comfort of knowing the fulfillment and the completion of all things, and that this is necessary, and we must know why. And how do we know why? By experiencing it and learning from it, you know. And so by living the teaching, by being the teaching, you know, living it, being it, becoming it, understanding it, and overcoming it, thus, stepping forward to, you know, closer to the fulfillment of that which is to basically just open way to bigger fulfillments, you know. And we're not going to get ahead of ourselves. So now let us return to Joseph in the pit. So now his brothers, they get rid of him, basically, and they, you know, maybe his brothers don't take that coat as being his protection, but we see it as kind of like the coat is only a shadow. The coat is only an Old Testament type. The protection is within Joseph. He is favored, and he keep it and maintain it, his integrity, and is lawful, you know. He remains true to to the laws of all things, and so conforms himself and allows himself to be molded and shaped into whatever it is that his creator wants him. And that is his responsibility, to accept that servitude. And so now, and the proof of this is that his faith will later establish the fact that his focus is not on the difficulties of the present time, but rather, once we have been given, and we that are the pupil, the apple of the eye of Jah, that have been given the vision, then all, you know, that is comfort. You know, Joseph, he may have been confronted with difficulties, but he knew the vision. You know, he had the dreams. He spoke the dreams, which is what got him in this mess, you know, to start with. But so now in that comfort, he could go on and fulfill his oath, which is to add to his blessing, to multiply. Joseph actually means Jah has added. That is the lesson here. So, keeping the vision. You know, whatever difficulties might lie ahead, they're part of the teaching to fulfill what is inevitably to be fulfilled, unless we short circuit or kind of, you know, reject the only good that will ever be presented to us. But in this case, it's not so. Joseph fulfills and keeps fulfilling and aligns himself to the will of the Almighty, and thus the Almighty is able to bring forth his the bigger picture. And within that bigger picture, there is a even bigger picture, but something that Joseph, we're not sure if he knew, he most likely did not know, but still him allowing himself to receive that spirit made it possible for Jah to do those things which inevitably will be done. And so what are we speaking about? The famine. Now Joseph, you know, he goes through a lot of stuff, but he only keeps on adding and multiplying his blessing. And so then the times of the famine come, and turns out that the vision become fulfilled, become revealed, becomes made manifest, no matter what anyone tries to do. And so that is the comfort of receiving the Spirit. And this, in a way, is kind of like, we receive it to be kind of like a teaching for the New Testament elect within the Old Testament types and actualities and historical facts and stuff like that. So now, one last thing, I guess, kind of that we need to make mention. Or actually, we'll hold on, because we don't, you know, just, this will fulfill the previous reasonings, and we'll come forth with that which we had in mind on the forward. So give thanks to all.